I'm going to show you how I created this infinitely zooming animation in After Effects. Let's begin. I created all of these vector elements in Illustrator and then moved into Photoshop to add the texture and a few other design elements, but we can recreate most of those in After Effects. I've imported that Illustrator file into After Effects and I've got each element separated on a different layer. I've made this comp 5 seconds long and called it Pizza 01. I'm going to create a new comp with these dimensions by dragging our pizza comp over the new composition icon here. And let's call that Zoom Main. To create our system for the infinite zoom, I'm first going to create a new null object by going up to our layer menu up here, selecting null object, or you can use the keyboard shortcut Control, Alt, Shift, and Y if you're a real hotshot. And that will create a null object in the very dead center of our comp. Now I made sure in Illustrator that the eye would be also the exact dead center of the comp, but this technique will work with anywhere being the center point of your infinite zoom in or zoom out. Just move your null to that area. Let's rename that null Master Scale, because we always label our layers. And let's parent our pizza comp to that null using our pick whip. We want to increase the scale of this null so that the eye in our pizza comp fills the whole screen. So let's press S on our keyboard to bring up the scale properties, hit the stopwatch here, and then around 2.5 seconds in, let's just drag this up until the black eye engulfs the whole screen. There we are, just under 6,000%. Now even though these are vector elements inside our pizza pre-comp, we do need to check the continuously rasterized box over here so that they don't get all pixelated as they scale. Now let's bring the end of our work area to where this keyframe is by pressing N on our keyboard so that our playback will loop these first few seconds. And when we play it back, the timing looks awful. You could fiddle around these with a graph editor to find a speed that you like, but for it to look like a continuous seamless zoom in, the increase needs to be exponential. And lucky for us, that's incredibly easy to do in After Effects. We just select both of those keyframes, right click, select keyframe assistant, and then exponential scale. After Effects will put a keyframe on every frame between those points. And if we go into the graph editor, we can see that they're on a precise exponential scale. Because these are all baked in keyframes, it's a little trickier to adjust the speed, but deleting those keyframes and starting again isn't really that big of a deal if you need the zoom in to happen a bit faster or a bit slower. Now, if we play it back, it's lovely and smooth and scaling up at a constant rate. Now, it's also a good opportunity to add a background. So I'm going to add a black solid by pressing Control Y. But we do need to have a second pizza that's scaling up from inside this eyeball. And so it isn't just blank and then snapping towards this new pizza in the beginning. To do that, we can duplicate our pizza comp with Control plus D. And then we remove its parent link from our master scale by selecting none over here. So we need this pizza to be exactly this size at the end of the work area. So let's go all the way over there and then parent it back to that master scale null. Now, because it's attached to that master scale none at a different point, it should play back seamlessly. Perfect. The only thing that sticks out is this small little pizza that just pops on in the middle when we get to the beginning of the loop. But we're going to take care of that and add some texture shading after a very quick word about this video sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is a huge online learner community with courses on a huge range of creative, productivity, and business skills from some of the best in the industry. With a premium membership, you get unlimited access to as many courses as you can possibly handle, including Animating with Ease by Jake Bartlett, Illustrated Lettering with Gemma O'Brien, Mastering Illustrator with DKNG, and one I can't wait to watch is Color Masterclass with Victor Onai. I think that following along with a structured course is the most guaranteed way to improve your skills. And with the annual subscription being less than $10 a month, I think it's one of the best investments for your career that you can make. Use the link in the description to get a 2-month free trial. Now the first thing here is get rid of this pizza popping in at the very beginning of this loop. We're going to do that by having the whole pizza being revealed by a textured wipe that we're going to do inside this pre-comp. I'm going to create a new black solid with Control Y. I'm going to grab my pen tool and then just draw a loose shape around our pizza. There we are. And I'm going to keyframe this mask's path by pressing M to reveal our mask path here, selecting the stopwatch, and then a few frames later, let's go and drag some of these points away so that our pizza is revealed. And because our pizza will be on a black background, it's going to look like it's emerging out of a shadow. If we navigate back to our main comp, we can see if we play it back, it's not working quite how we want it, because both of these pizza comps are being revealed at the same time at the very beginning. This larger, scaled-up pizza comp shouldn't be being revealed at all. It should have already done this animation. So to move this bottom, more scaled-up comp backwards in time, I'm going to go to the very end of our work area here, and I'm going to add a marker to this layer by pressing asterisk on our keyboard. And then I'm just going to slide this marker way over to the start of our comp. So now this bottom comp here will continue the animation where it cuts off at the end of this loop here. Now, as I'm saying that, I'm aware it sounds a bit like crazy talk. So this comp here has an animation inside that pre-comp, which at the moment is just this wipe reveal at the start. And then 2 seconds in, when this loop ends, we need that to be taken over by this bottom comp over here, which is why we've slid it back 2 seconds so that this larger comp is always 2.5 seconds ahead of our smaller comp, and therefore it will loop seamlessly. I hope that makes sense. Dig around in the project file if you're unsure. Now let's go and add some texture. I'm going to add grain to this reveal by feathering the mask, by pressing F and then dragging the feathering up until it looks kinda nice. And then I'm going to change the blending mode to dissolve. Maybe that feathering was a bit too much. I go into depth on using this technique in my grain shading tutorial. I'm also going to add some grain to the pepperoni. So I'm going to duplicate this pepperoni layer, rename it. I'm going to change the fill color to black. And then select our pen tool, make sure we're selecting Tool Creates Masks up here. And then I'm just going to draw a roundish shape on the top right of all of these pepperonis. And then add a feather to all of them and change the blending mode to dissolve. And because the scale of this comp is going to be increasing massively in our main comp, let's pop out there and see how this looks in context. It's not too bad, but I think we should decrease the feathering a little bit on these pepperonis. One of the reasons I like to use the dissolve method here is because as this scales up, the feathering of the mask maintains in the right proportion, so the gradient never changes. But the detail in the dissolve of the grain, it is always detailed and it's always crisp. There's nothing worse than a blurry, pixelated texture that's been scaled up too much. I've also added some shading to the crust using the same method. Now I want to add a bit of red shading inside the black eye. So I've used the same technique, I've got a red duplicate of this eye here, but when I add the dissolve and the feathered mask, it's a bit hard to tell how it's going to look when it's scaled up, because this is such a small part of this little comp here. So I just made sure to swap between the main comp every once in a while, just to make sure it was working properly. See here, this seems a bit too much, like it's encroaching on the eye, so I'm going to go back in and push it a bit further towards the edge. And it's just a bit hard to tell inside this comp what it's going to look like out there. And we need to set the feathering really low. I might go as low as 6 pixels here to match how it will look when it's scaled up at 6,000%. There, that's not too bad. Back in our main comp, I've added 3 effects to help tie this all together. I've added an adjustment layer with a turbulent displace effect on there. I've set the size right down to the minimum of 2 pixels and the amount to 30. And this just helps give the edges a bit of, you know, irregularity on those clean vector shapes. And it also helps push the crunchiness of that dissolve blending mode a bit further and makes them mash into each other, and you get a bit more of a softer gradient in between them, which I think just looks a bit more natural and textured. I've then added this light looping texture over the top. This is a looping texture I use in almost all of my illustrations. It is just a piece of paper that I painted black, and I've got it, you know, rotating and looping 4 times, and I've just put that on a loop. I go into more detail on how to create these from scratch in my looping texture tutorial, but you can nab this one from the working files if you want. I've then added an adjustment layer with the posterized time effect set to 12.5 frames per second. This is because I generally prefer the look of things animated on 2s at 12 frames a second, but that's a personal preference and not necessary at all. If you want that super buttery smooth, you can go to 25 or 30 or even higher if you want. One last thing I've done is place that entire main comp into a new comp that's scaled down to 1080 by 1080 pixels wide. This is for the final export, and I'm mainly doing this so that when we scale down that main comp, and I'm mainly doing that to get a nice result in these sort of noisy textures here. By scaling it down and using that turbulent displace effect earlier, you really remove a lot of the nasty crunchiness that you'd get with the normal dissolve blending mode here. So we go from this here on the left to this on the right, just by scaling it down and then adding that turbulent displace effect. And this just turns it into a nice, pleasant, textured gradient. I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.